we are here to study continuous ice cream freezer. So here we can see that this is the ice cream mix transfer line. So from the aging tank, after homogenization, ice cream mix will enter to this pipeline and it will be supplied to the ice cream freezer. So here we are seeing that this pipeline is transferring the ice cream mix via this pipe to this particular end. So this is the inlet port of the ice cream freezer. So the product will enter at this side, and also we are seeing that this is leading to a positive displacement from here. So this is a rotary vane type or a gear type of pump in which a fixed metered quantity of ice cream mix will be fed into the ice cream freezer or barrel. We have one more connection shown to you here. So this connection is for compressed air supply. So for producing the overrun for the ice cream mix, we require air incorporation. As this is continuous process, so continuously air will be also required to enter into the system. This air line is connected to this pressure gauge. So here we will be seeing how much pressure is there in the compressed air line. It will be going to this part, which is the filter as well as regulator of the air. So it will filter out whatever dust, dirt or impurities, if any, are there, and also regulate the quantity of air going into the system. So it will lead to this particular pipeline here we can see. So this is at the back side of the freezer. We are having product entering at this side and air entering from top at this side. So this is the inner cylinder or barrel of this machine, which is a double jacketed cylinder. So here we are seeing the inner cylinder, which will be carrying our ice cream mix as well as air, and it has been then surrounded by this larger diameter cylinder vessel, which is a kind of shell and tube type of heat exchanger. So inside the central tube, which is only one single tube, we are having ice cream mix with the air. Outside in that, this barrel, we will be having refrigerant. So refrigerant in the form of liquid ammonia from the refrigeration system or plant, from the plant will be coming to refrigerate the content. So here we can see that in this barrel, we are having this outlet. So at this outlet, the frozen mass, which is still in flowable form, that means a kind of soft serve type of consistency of ice cream will be coming out at about -4°C, and it will be then discharged through this another positive displacement pump of a larger size than that inlet. It will be directed to this valve here. So this is a three-way valve. So depending on its position, we can direct this ice cream either towards this end or to the other pipeline side. So depending on whether we are required to manually fill it, take a sample, or to let it to go to some packaging machine, we can switch this valve to a selected direction. So if we are required to manually fill ice cream, we can direct this ice cream to come at this end by switching this valve in this opposite direction, by opening this valve and then rotating this into this direction. So by using this direction, what we can have is, we can have this control, the ice cream to flow to this direction. If we are required to make the flow of ice cream to this part of pipeline, then we can again switch this valve in this particular direction, so that whatever contents are forced by this positive displacement pump can go to this pipeline. So this pipeline is leading via this connection to the next machine, which is cup filling machine. Now coming on to the back side of the machine, we can here see that we are having these pipelines connected to this ice cream machine. So here we are seeing that we are having these insulated and uninsulated lines. So these uninsulated lines are coming from the liquid ammonia receiver of refrigeration plant, and this insulated line is going to the compressor of the refrigerant plant. Now how to identify which line is incoming and which line is outgoing is like that. Liquid ammonia, which is coming from the receiver of refrigerant plant, is near to ambient temperature and hence it does not require any insulation. And the vapor ammonia, which is spent in the refrigeration of ice cream mix, will be cold in temperature and is required to be protected from environmental temperature so that heat loss does not occur. So that is why it is heavily insulated, which can can be seen here. And also there is one more difference, that the diameter of liquid ammonia line is smaller than the diameter of vapor ammonia line, as we know that specific volume of liquid will be lesser than specific volume of vapors. So here we can see at this back side, we are having this main motor which is connected via this power transmission system, which is a V-belt, to this gearbox. So this gearbox will be running the scraper and agitator of the machine, as well as also mounted to the air compressor. So inside the main barrel, we are having heater and dasher assembly, which I have already covered in the theory class, and that heater and dasher assembly will be used to continuously scrap and scrap the contents of the product and air, so that air incorporates while freezing of the ice cream. Now coming on to the air control, how air will be controlled is by using this screw here. So if we tighten this screw here, then less amount of air will be going into the system. If we loosen this screw, more air will be going. So hence we can control the overrun or amount of air going into the system by using this screw here. For controlling the amount of mix going into the system, we are having this gear or log pump type of mechanism. Its rotation can be controlled to control the rate of flow.